What is going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. After Sound here, bringing you Splinterlands content every single day. We also stream right here on this channel every Tuesday, Thursday, and Sunday morning. So come by and say hello. Okay, well, I did it. I caved. I got a node, or node license, I should say, validator license. And here are just some things that I wanted to share with you because I have seen a bit of an uptick. I have seen a bit of interest in the comments section as people consider this. And so I wanted to give at least two things to think about, right? This isn't necessarily, you know, I'm not trying to dissuade you or persuade you into getting one. I just want you to think about these things before you jump in head first because some random dude on YouTube was talking about it too much, right? So here we go. So I bought it, and the first thing that I will say is to be very, very conscious of SPS price and where you are buying SPS. Now, keep in mind, SPS is a dynamic token that exists on multiple different exchanges and trading platforms, and each of those places has its own price for SPS based on the supply-demand economics of that small ecosystem, as well as the broader market in general. So, for example, the main place that you should be looking at, and I just refreshed this page, so you should be looking down to see here, what does Splinterlands for node license sales consider the market price of SPS? Right now, it's 0.066 USD, right? Now, the thing is, if you go to, we'll go to Hive Engine first, and you can see here, Hive Engine is probably going to be one of the easiest ways for people to get into. Well, now, look at this. It's considering 0.0663 versus 0.0661. So there's already a slight discrepancy there, which doesn't seem like a lot, but when you're talking on a scale of a couple thousand dollars, it can add up. Not only that, so for example, like I got mine through a different exchange, not through Hive Engine. And I went through Binance Smart Chain. But here, check this out. Let me refresh this. The official price on CoinGecko is 0.064. So we're already starting to see significant differences across the board. Now, when you go to CoinGecko or CoinMarketCap, you can go down to the Splinterlands markets and you can see here what the price is currently on each of these markets. So if you were to buy on like PancakeSwap, for example, it's 0.065. Crypto.com is 0.065. Gate.io is 0.064, right? So there's several different places. You can also see, and I would say that this is probably an important thing to consider, the volume, right? So where is there a lot of volume happening? Where are a lot of these trades happening? Well, LBank seems to be one of the highest with $350,000. PancakeSwap, which exists on the Binance Smart Chain, is coming in second at $200,000. So there's a lot of volume back and forth, which means that the price adjustment, if you're putting in a lot of money, shouldn't be, you know, it shouldn't move the market as much. So what is that called? Let me look it up here. The slippage and let's see if not the slippage, the price impact, that is what I'm referring to. So the price impact will be minimal on markets that will have much more volume. And if we go back to here, you can see that the 24-hour volume for SPS on Hive Engine is 26 grand. So you could move the market relatively quickly on Hive Engine. Am I saying that Hive Engine is the best place to buy or the worst place to buy? No, but I'm saying that there's a lot less liquidity on there. And as you can see, the price is 0.066 versus some of the other markets that you can get it on. That being said, in order to get that SPS into the game, you're probably going to have to pay the Terablock fee. So these are all things to keep in mind as you go through and try to figure out the best way and the cheapest way to get a node. The other thing to keep in mind is don't forget that you can get a significant discount with the vouchers. I mean, vouchers are trading for $1.08 right now, which means that on half, right? So the nodes are going for $3,000 right now, but you can get up to half of that back in, or used for vouchers, right? You can spend 500 vouchers and 1500 USD. The fact is you can get one or two thirds off of the voucher side of it, right? Because these vouchers should technically be trading for $3. Well, I shouldn't say they should technically be trading, but they have a value when you're going for nodes of $3 and you can buy them for $1.08. So Just things to think about. Keep in mind, at this point in time, nobody should be buying with only SPS. If you are coming in and looking at this price and being like, okay, I'm going to need, you know, 45,000 SPS in order to buy this, bring in the 45,000 SPS, but you're actually going to be able to pay much less than that. And if you see here, I would say that this is a good proxy, but the license node sale is going to be a rough proxy for how much you could spend if you were to save using vouchers, because this is the price on the secondary market. And so this is always going to be priced right around, sometimes a little bit more, sometimes a little less, but whenever it's less than whatever it is to buy on the actual site, it gets scooped up very quickly, right? And that can happen because the price of Hive is very dynamic and moves back and forth, and that can change. So this isn't really priced in USD. On Hive Engine, things are priced in Hive, and since Hive is a dynamic token with a dynamic price, it can go back and forth. So something to be, you might be able to get like a pretty good deal, but what I use this for is just a relative proxy on how, what is the value of a node right now, right? They're selling for $3,000, but that's not how much they actually are in value. You can get one on the secondary market for $2,000, and you can also get one here. If we just do the quick math, what is 1.08 times 500 plus the 1500? So you can see if you go into, if you were to buy that many vouchers right now at this price point, and we're going to get into that in a second. If you were to buy that many vouchers, you'd be paying roughly like $50 less than buying it on the secondary market. So this usually will always be just a little bit higher so that there's an arbitrage there. Somebody's able to buy it off the main site and then sell it for like $50 more. Does that always happen? Am I recommending doing that trade? I wouldn't think so, because, you know, like I said, Hive is a dynamic token and the price can kind of flutter around. And if you get screwed and Hive goes down in value and someone comes in with a bunch of dollars in with a bunch of value in USD, they could essentially buy it for less than the amount on the actual website. Now, the last thing, and this is more of, I guess, just a general warning, because I'm seeing it very prevalent across the community on Discord and just everywhere. But it's this idea that you could get, you know, your ROI back in a matter of days, right? Or in a matter of weeks or months. I'm always wary of that. Okay. And the thing is, you know, it's a nice talking point, and I'm sure that I've been guilty of it in the past, saying like, hey, check out this APR. You can make your money back in X amount of time. But what I've learned from the Stepin situation, what I've seen from other projects that have like high APRs or high returns on investment, is that it's only a snapshot in time. It's only a snapshot in time. And the problem is that you're going to go in thinking that, okay, let's say, you know, right now, let's do a real example here. You got 20,000 vouchers, or 20,000 node license, I'm sorry, 20,000 vouchers divided by roughly, what is this? So 2630, right? Yeah, 2630 node licenses that have been sold. That means that everybody's getting roughly 7.6 vouchers per day. Multiply that by the 1.08 value in vouchers, so $8.21. So if you spend, what did we say, 2040 divided by 8.12, oh my gosh, you can make your money back in 250 days, or 8.3 months, two-thirds of a year. That sounds awesome, right? Who wouldn't want to do that? You can make your APR sounds amazing. The problem is that this is a snapshot in time. And as we go further along, once tranche one sells out, for example, this will drop down to four vouchers per day per node, right? Because we'll have 5,000 nodes, and that's 20,000 divided by five is four vouchers per node. So you take a look at that and say, okay, well, all of a sudden it's like 2040 divided by I don't know, we're just going to say $4.50, right, for the vouchers, and all of a sudden you're more than a year. So this is going to be a moving target that will be getting farther away over time, okay? I just want people to be aware of that, because it's not like, okay, I'm going to make back my money like right away and this is going to be great. This is a great investment. In fact, I would recommend that you watch the video that I posted yesterday on why I feel like I need to buy a node, and ultimately I ended up doing so. But in that reason, it wasn't because I thought that it was a great investment. It's because there was a fear of missing out on what potential value could be given to the nodes, right, versus SPS. So in that way, this is, again, being bought from me as a hedge against that, due to the fact that I have a good position with an SPS, I want to make sure that I'm kind of diversified now, seeing as you know, due to this action, SPS has been devalued. So maybe I shouldn't be holding as much SPS and I should be getting into other areas. I didn't buy this because I'm like, oh man, the APR is so high and I'm going to make back my money really quick. And I think that's a really dangerous way to go about it. Again, like I said, I learned from the step inside where so many people aped into the project because of the fact that it was like, oh my gosh, you can make your money back in 30 days, right? You buy this, you go for a walk, and you make your money back in 30 days. I knew that wasn't going to be the case. So I bought one shoe just to try and be part of the ecosystem and see what all of the hype was about. Because what ended up happening is the prices tanked over time due to the fact that there was this sell pressure. Everybody bought in and then was like, I need to make my money back, so I'm going to sell the rewards token, and that ended up tanking the market. Actually, not even just that. A lot of other factors came in, including one that we have zero control over, which is what happens with the broader economy, what happens with Bitcoin and the crypto markets. You guys know me. I am very much in bear mode right now when it comes to the crypto markets as well as the global economy. I don't think we felt maximum pain yet. I think that's still coming. So Bitcoin dipped down yesterday to like 27,000, I think. Ethereum's getting hit like crazy. I saw it at 14 something. So all of these are just signs to me that this is, don't get into this for the investment right now, because if you were expecting an ROI or you want some crazy passive income, what happens if voucher prices go below a dollar? What happens if, due to the fact that we have double the amount of vouchers now, voucher prices come down to, I don't know, maybe half? What if they're at 50 cents, 60 cents? Look at that. All of a sudden, your ROI is going to, like, your return on investment is going to take you maybe multiple years at this point in time. And I know I'm being super bearish right now, not on Splinterlands, but just on the general market. I don't know that we come out of, or we get another bull run until Bitcoin's next halving, which is 2 years away, or almost 2 years away. So when you are going to make a decision like this, just think about why you're doing it. Be very thoughtful about where you are getting the assets from, what kind of return you expect from it, and then make that decision there, right? But like, I just don't want people aping into this and then, you know, in a couple of months, let's say the SPS rewards get delayed and we don't get those in August, people are going to be complaining, being like, I need that, right? And then also, if you have a bunch of people who are buying into this now, they're going to be the ones dumping the vouchers on the market because they're like, well, I need to make an ROI on my investment, and voucher prices are going down, so I should sell while there's value right now, right? Like, I saw that in Stepin, I'm seeing it in other projects that I'm not involved with but following closely. And it's like this kind of death spiral that will happen. Again, I don't think that the game is going to die. I don't think nodes are going to die. When I say death spiral, it's this self-fulfilling prophecy of, I need to get an ROI on my investment, so let me sell now to get that back. And my ROI is only X amount of days away. But that will be a moving target that gets further and further away, unless and until we get some more utility to some of the tokens here that can buck the trend of the broader crypto and global markets. But until we get that, and until Splinterlands can prove that they can do that, and again, this is not a knock on the Splinterlands team. Every project is trying to do this right now. Every project is trying to look at Bitcoin, give it the middle finger, and be like, no, our token is going to succeed. Are they doing that? No, because it's a difficult thing to do. But I do have a lot of faith in the Splinterlands team. Otherwise, I wouldn't be out here buying a node or continuing to play or making a bunch of content around it. So that's all I'm saying to you. Just beware of a lot of the hype that you listen to. Again, I'm not trying to, you know, take shots at anyone by any means. I'm just trying to get you to be more thoughtful before you jump in because you saw some crazy statistic about, you know, an APR that you could get your money back in a couple of months. I just want you to be thoughtful about where the world is, where the market is, where the development of this game is, and what you could reasonably expect if you are going into this as an investment versus just trying to diversify the assets that you have within the game and partake in the decentralization aspect of it, which is what the nodes are really all about. So that is all I have for you. Have an amazing rest of your day. I will catch you all in the next video, and I will see you around the game. Take care.